हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड हेल्दी। सो हियर आई एम मिस प्रतीक्षा सिंह कनेक्टिंग यूअर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन सेकेंड टॉपिक दैट इज सेंटर ऑफ मास। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन लीनियर मोमेंटम अबाउट सेंटर ऑफ मास एंड सम सैम्पल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स रिगार्डिंग टू दोज टॉपिक्स। ओके, सो एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी वॉट इज एंगुलर मोमेंटम for a system of particles and what is the law of angular momentum. So let us begin with the definition of angular momentum. Now, angular momentum of a particle about a reference point O. Suppose if there is a particle present at position, if you see a dotted point, that is a object or a particle, okay, and it is a reference means at position r bar from point O, right? It is at a distance r bar from point O. What is O? O is the origin, or we can say it is a reference point. So angular momentum of that particle is defined as the vector product of the position relative to the reference point and momentum of the particle. Vector product here we have to give. What is vector product? It is a cross product between two quantities. So what are the two quantities? That is r bar and p bar. R bar is the position vector, or we can say it is the distance between the point and origin or reference point. Okay, so that is r bar. And what is p bar? P bar is the linear momentum. We have seen in previous lecture what is p bar. P bar is the linear momentum, that is P is equal to m into v. Okay, so angular momentum r bar is defined as the vector product or cross product of two quantities, that is position vector and linear momentum. So the formula becomes L bar is equal to r bar cross P bar, where L bar is the It is a symbolic form of angular momentum. Angular momentum is denoted by L bar and linear momentum is denoted by P bar. So the formula becomes L bar is equal to R bar cross P bar. Now, angular momentum of a point particle. So if there is a point particle having mass m is moving with velocity v. Okay, just consider there is a point having mass m, okay, and that particle is having velocity v. So linear momentum of that particle will be p is equal to m into v, that is linear momentum is equal to product of mass and velocity m into v. Suppose there is a fixed point s and vector rs bar from the point s to the location of the object. There is a position vector, that is rs bar, from point S to the location of the object. Location of the object means where the position of that particle or where that object is present. Now, how we can calculate the angular momentum for that individual particle? That is L bar is equal to ls bar. S is for that fixed point S, like we can say a reference point. So ls bar is equal to rs bar cross p bar. Okay, bar represented for vector quantity. Both angular momentum and linear momentum as well as the position vectors are vector quantity. So that's why we have written there as a bar. Ls bar is equal to rs bar cross p bar. What will be the unit of the angular momentum? The SI unit for angular momentum is kilogram meter square per second. Now let us see the derivation for angular momentum in terms of torque. Now in linear momentum, we have seen the net force is equal to dp upon dt, right? In linear momentum. But similarly, we can write in the form of torque for angular momentum, right? Torque is represented by symbol tau. So net tau is equal to dl upon dt. This is for single particle. But if there are n number of particles are present, then we can write the vector sum of all torques acting on a particle is equal to the time rate of change of angular momentum of that particle. So let us see how this will be. L bar is equal to m in bracket r bar cross v bar. L bar is angular momentum, and we can write it as mass in bracket position vector, that is r bar, cross cross product of position vector r bar and velocity, that is v bar. Now if we differentiate this term with respect to time, then we get dl upon dt is equal to m in bracket. Now again we have to differentiate r bar cross v bar as well. So here there is a product of r bar and v bar. So product of any two quantities, if we have to differentiate, then we must use the formula of u into v. You must know uv rule of differentiation, that is d by dt of u into v is equal to u and derivative of v plus v into derivative of u, right? So similarly we have write differentiation of r bar cross v bar as r bar cross dv by dt plus dr by dt cross v bar. Now after that, in next step, if you see the formula for acceleration or definition of acceleration, it is the rate of change of velocity, right? So in the place of dv by dt we have write a bar, that is acceleration. And similarly for the definition of velocity, it is rate of change of displacement or rate of change of position with respect to time. So dr by dt is replaced by velocity, that is v bar. Now expression becomes dl upon dt is equal to m in bracket r bar cross a bar plus v bar cross v bar. Now if there are two similar terms are in cross product, then the answer is 1, right? So v bar cross v bar is 1. So what remains? M in bracket r bar cross a bar. So we get dl by dt is equal to m in bracket r bar cross a bar. Now if we open the bracket, then we get dl bar upon dt is equal to r bar cross m into a bar, that is mass into acceleration. So according to Newton's first law, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So replace m into a bar by f bar, okay? So we get dl bar upon dt is equal to r bar cross f bar net, okay? Now if there are n number of particles present, then we will here summation all, add up the all the individual particles. So summation of r bar cross f bar will give you net torque of the all system of particles. So here we get the vector sum of all torque acting on a particle, that is equal to the time rate of change of angular momentum of that particular particle. Okay. So if there are n number of particles present in a system, if you see in diagram, there are n number of particles are present having masses m1, m2, m3 up to mn, and they also having position vector r1, r2, r3 up to rn, and the velocities of these particles are v1, v2, v3 up to vn, and there is a center of mass of all these particles lie at the mid position. Okay, so total angular momentum of such a system is given as L is equal to L1 bar plus L2 bar plus L3 bar plus Ln bar, means total of all individual angular momentums, that is summation I is equal to 1 to n Li bar, right, where I is 1 to n. So total angular momentum of a system of particles is defined as the vector sum of the angular momentum of all individual particles, that is L total is equal to L1 plus L2 plus L3 up to Ln, that is summation Li. And if we differentiate this with respect to time, we get dL total upon dt is equal to summation tau I. Tau means torque, net torque acting on such a particles. Right? So I hope you must get this point. Next, we will see law of conservation of angular momentum. According to rotational dynamics, tau s, that is external torque, is equal to dls upon dt. Right? Rate of change of angular momentum with respect to time is equal to net torque acting on the body. Okay? If there is no external torque present, that is torque is zero, then dl upon dt is also zero. That means change in angular momentum is zero. Change in angular momentum means delta, that is delta ls is zero, and delta ls is also right as final angular momentum minus initial angular momentum, right? That is lsf minus lsi, that is final angular momentum minus initial angular momentum, is equal to zero. So that means final angular momentum is equals to initial angular momentum, that is angular momentum is conserved. Lsf is equal to Lsi. So far no isolated system has been encountered such that angular momentum is not constant. So according to the law of conservation of angular momentum, if there is no external torque acting on object, that time no change of angular momentum will occur, right? So this is somehow similar to law of conservation of linear momentum. It was when there is no external force acting on a body, then linear momentum is constant or conserved. Similarly here, if there is no torque, external torque acting on a body, then angular momentum is conserved, right? So both the laws are somehow similar to each other. Now see example of law of conservation of angular momentum. Here is a girl is skating or spinning on the tip of her skate with her arms extended. If you see in first diagram, the girl is spinning on the tip of her skate with her arms extended, right? So at this position her velocity relatively small. Okay, see, she is moving slowly around her own imaginary axis. Okay, her angular momentum is conserved because the net torque acting on her body is negligibly small. That's why angular momentum is constant. But in next image, if you see, her rate of spinning is increases greatly when she pulls her arms inside. Right? When she pulls her arms inside, her rate of spin is increases greatly and moment of inertia decreases. So if you compare both two images, first one where her arms are extended outside, that time her radius of the spin is larger and velocity by which she is spinning is smaller. Okay, that means radius and velocity, these both terms are inversely proportional to each other, right? Radius is larger, velocity is smaller. But in second image, when she pull her arms inside, that time her radius of spin is smaller. So radius decreases, her velocity increases. So velocity or the speed by which she is spinning is increases greatly as compared to first one. So remember that as radius increases, velocity decreases, and as radius decreases, velocity increases. Means these two terms are inversely proportional to each other, and this is happens just to conserve angular momentum. Okay, so this is the best example of law of conservation of angular momentum, that is ice skating. Now see some sample objectives on this topic, that is angular momentum and law of angular momentum. The first one, that is angular momentum, is denoted by which symbol, whether it is P, L, R or V. So if you see, L is the correct answer, right? Angular momentum is denoted by L, and P, it was linear momentum. P symbol is used for linear momentum, R is for radius, and V is for velocity. So for angular momentum, the symbol used is L. Then second question, torque means what? Whether it is couple of velocity, whether it is couple of momentum, or couple of force, or none of them. So the correct answer for this is third option, that is couple of force. Torque is couple of force. Then third question, if torque is dash dash, then angular momentum is conserved. Now just remind the law of conservation of angular momentum. If torque is smaller, or torque is greater, or torque is 0, or torque is 1. When torque is 0, that time only angular momentum is conserved. If you go to the slide of law of conservation of angular momentum, you will get the answer, that is torque is 0 for conserving the angular momentum. Now see fourth and last question. In conservation of angular momentum, if R decreases, then V dash dash. So this was the question from the example of law of conservation of angular momentum. You have seen the example, that is ice skating. So you must get the answer, that is if R decreases, then V must be increases. Right? So this is the correct answer. If R decreases, then V increases, because radius and the velocity, these two terms are inversely proportional to each other. So as one term increases, second term must be decreases. So if R decreases, then V increases. Okay. So write these all points in your notebook, remind it, revise it, and write this MCQ also as well, and solve them properly and prepare for your exams. We will see next topic or next lesson in next video. Till then, thank you and bye bye.